And I say to Sayyida Khadija, oh Sayyida Khadija, you were oppressed now and you were oppressed when you died. Someone says, what do you mean you were oppressed when you died? You know Rasulullah, when he came to bury Bibi Khadija, he came, but because they were so poor, the kafan that he had was not long enough to cover her body. Rasulullah looked up towards the heavens. He said, Ya Allah, I am your prophet. And this is Khadija. I have no kafan long enough. I beg you, Ya Allah, answer my dua. The narrations say at this moment, Jibreel came to Rasulullah with 5 kafans. He came with 5 kafans. Rasulullah looked at him. He said to him, Jibreel, tell me who is the first kafan for? He said to him, Ya Rasulullah, the first kafan. Ya Rasulullah, the first kafan is for your wife Khadija. He said to him, Jibreel, tell me who the second kafan is for. He said to him, Ya Rasulullah, the second kafan is for you, so that when you die, there is a kafan to cover your body. He said to him, Jibreel, tell me who is the third kafan for? He said to him, Ya Rasulullah, the third kafan is for Fatima al-Zahra, that when she dies, there is a kafan to cover her body. He said to him, Jibreel, tell me who is the fourth kafan for? He said to him, Ya Rasulullah, the fourth kafan is for Ali ibn Abi Talib, that when he dies, there is a kafan to cover his body. He said to him, Ya Rasulullah, he looked at him and said, Ya Jibreel, tell me who is the fifth kafan for? He said to him, Ya Rasulullah, the fifth kafan is for your grandson Hassan, that when he dies, there is a kafan to cover his body. He looked at him and he said to him, Jibreel, tell me where is the kafan for Abu Abdullah? Jibreel, tell me where is the kafan for Abu Abdullah? He said to me, Ya Rasulullah, Abu Abdullah will die without a kafan on his body. He said to him, Jibreel, why? He said to him, because the horses of Bani Umayyah will trample on the body of Abu Abdullah.